Hello there all, and welcome to a follow-up to the Meatstick review, and of course, my final thoughts. After I did another two smokes on my grill, I have finally come to the conclusion of what my final thoughts are on the Meatstick, as shown here. But before I get into the final review, there are a few things that I need to clear up about the first review on this Meatstick. And if you haven't seen my first review, well, I'll put a card up here for you to check out. First, I did go a bit strong on the whole rechargeable batteries. And well, I wanted to be clear, if you really want rechargeable, you can put rechargeable batteries in there. And as well, the company did let me know that their first products did come with the rechargeable battery, but due to the high demand and volume of usage, it was found to be easier just to have it include batteries. So I believe the best of both worlds kind of fall into this right here. Buy rechargeable batteries, like the ones I'm showing, put them in there, and then get another set and swap them out as they discharge. Kind of like the perfect world of both, right? Second, again, the company did let me know that they had considered the ability to monitor the grill while setting up and getting the grill up to temperature. At this time, they found it more important to focus on the product, working on the monitoring of the food itself, and that maybe there might be something in the near future. What they mean is there might be a possibility, who knows, of something that could monitor the temperature as you set up your grill. I don't know. As soon as I know, I will let you know. And third, I discovered that if you place the probe kind of on the side of the meat and ensure that it's not blocked by any meat or any other object in the grill area, the temperature is going to be a bit more accurate for the ambient temperature sensing side. Okay, so let's talk about what you came here for. My final judgment and thoughts on the Meatstick. At this time, I am comparing the Meatstick to the Inkbird that I reviewed earlier. I'll put a card up here as well for you to check out. So I pointed out the pros and the cons on the Meatstick. And I also stated, who is this for? But in the end, I reserved my judgment on this because I didn't have enough time with this device. And you know, I wanted to give you my honest opinion on this. Well, now I have. I've had two cooks and I have decided what I think of this device. One, the Meatstick distance range was greater than the Inkbird. I mean, distance like away from the cook. The Inkbird was quite impressive, but I'm telling you, the Meatstick was better. Two, no wires. Sorry, I just like that there are no wires on this Meatstick. As with the Inkbird, where I had to take out the probes when I went to go wrap up my ribs, as an example, and anytime I needed to move the meat around and away from the grill, I had to consider where should I put the wires because I could possibly cause damage. Not with this. Last but most important, and honestly what really sold this for me, is the Meatstick seemed more accurate in temperature monitoring than the Inkbird did. As I compared it to the ambient temperature on the dome of the Big Green Egg, while it is analog, the Meatstick seemed to be much closer aligned to the temperature on the Big Green Egg than the Inkbird did. Initially, I was concerned of the fact that there were some accuracy concerns of the cooks, as well as there were some reviews online that stated that there were accuracy issues with the Meatstick. And I found that while there was some learning with the Meatstick, after I was able to better get associated with the placement, then the cooking was so much better on this Meatstick. Now, the big issue with the not being able to monitor the prep of the grill, getting it up to temperature and having this inside, until it meets the desired temperature to start cooking on, well, that's what the ambient temperature on the grill is for, right? I mean, I'm usually near the grill while I'm starting it up, putting in the wood for the smoke. Lastly, putting in the big stone for the indirect cooking, I'm usually not too worried about getting it up to usually like 225. I am, however, most concerned that once I put this in the meat and get the meat into the grill, I'm worried about temperature climbs and or drops that are significant during the smoke process, and of course also the cooking of the food. That's what I'm okay with. I'm not too concerned about that I have to monitor the prep as I get up to temperature. But I'm gonna tell you this, there was a slight hint like maybe that the Meatstick might have something like an independent ambient probe.
Objection, speculation.
Or something else that allows you to monitor the setup on the grill. And that's gonna completely change the dynamic of the decision and almost completely in the favor of the Meatstick. While I'm already sounding like I'm in favor of the Meatstick, wink, wink, I am, adding something else would just be phenomenal. I would love to know your thoughts on this product and what you think would be important for your cooking adventures. Please let me know down in the comments what you like to cook and what you like to use to monitor your temperatures. So while you're there, please hit that subscribe button and click that bell so that you can be notified on other videos like this that I post at a later time. As an example, I will be doing a later review on a, right there, the Meatstick Wi-Fi extender that allows you to go anywhere as long as there's an internet connection to monitor your cook. I'll be putting that thing to the test. Stay tuned. And if you don't mind, please hit that like button if you found this to be helpful in any way for you. In the end, I chose this meat stick over the Inkbird because, well, it's wireless, right? It has a great and easy to follow dashboard. I really love that dashboard. And more importantly, it seems to be more accurate. Thank you, and of course to all of you out there, thanks so much for watching. Peace.